Mr. President, I rise today to speak regarding the impeachment of President Donald Trump. For more than 2 weeks now, the Senate has listened as both the House managers and the President's counsel have presented their cases. Nearly 28,000 pages of documents, including testimony from 17 witnesses gathered as part of the House investigation, were made part of the Senate record. Over the course of 2 days, senators asked 180 questions of the House managers and the White House counsel. The Senate took its constitutional duty very seriously. After carefully listening to the House managers, President's counsel, reviewing the documents and testimony, and asking questions, it is clear to me that the House should not have impeached President Trump, and the Senate should vote to acquit the President. The House process did not provide the President with important due process rights. On the other hand, the Senate trial was conducted using past precedent of the Clinton trial as the framework. At the start of the Senate trial, the Senate agreed that the House evidence could be admitted into the record. We provided ample opportunity for both the House managers and White House counsel to make their arguments and ensured that senators had substantial time to ask their questions. As I said, in fact, senators asked 180 questions over 2 full days and received lengthy answers from both and detailed answers from both President's counsel and the House managers. The American public has seen the transcript of the call between President Trump and President Zelensky. President Zelensky has said on several occasions that he did not feel pressured to do anything in return for the security assistance. Further, the military aid was provided to Ukraine without any investigations being conducted. Given these facts, the House's allegations do not rise to the level of an impeachable offense. Our founding fathers believed that impeachment should not be used as a partisan weapon, and that the president serves at the will of the people. With an election to be held in coming months, it should be up to the American people to decide who will lead the country. We need to put this impeachment behind us. We need to get back to work advancing measures to help improve the lives of Americans. These legislative priorities, delayed while the House and Senate focused its attention on partisan impeachment, include important items like addressing our nation's infrastructure, lowering prescription drug costs, providing middle-class tax relief, promoting American energy development, supporting our military and veterans, upholding our trust and treaty obligations to our tribal communities, securing our borders, and continuing to fight for our farmers and our ranchers. These should all be areas where we can work together on a bipartisan basis for the American people. With these important priorities in mind, I look forward to getting back to work for the American people. And with that, Mr. President, I yield the floor.